My dear young scientists of class 4, I am your science teacher. Get ready for your science class. Students, hope you are happy and healthy and enjoying this new teaching learning process. Students, before announcing today's chapter number 2 of class 4, general science, I am going for nature walk. Would you like to join me? Yes. If yes, what are you waiting for? Follow me. Students, now you can see I am somewhere outside and now I want to show you something all around. Students, just see what is visible to you all around. If I am not wrong, it's greenery. And this greenery is because of these plants. Yes, our topic for today, chapter number 2 of class 4 is plants. You can see some herbs, some shrubs, and many other plants. Now, my dear kids, you can see one plant is here, one tomato plant. In class 3 also, you have learnt about the plant. But now let us recall what you have learnt and part of the plant along with their function. Now, students, the part of the plant which is not visible to you under the soil is the root. The function of the root is it holds the plant tightly in the soil. Now this is what? Stem. The role of the stem is it supports the plant and keeps the plant upright straight. Now look at this. Leaves. These leaves are green because they have chlorophyll pigment in them. And it is important part of the plant because it helps in making food for the plant. Now what are these? Cute tomatoes. These are the fruit of the plant. Now they contain the seeds and when they ripen, they fall on the ground and after coming with the support of the all appropriate conditions, they grow into a new plant. Now here are some flowers also, some attractive and beautiful part of the plant. Now you can see some big trees also all around, big lean tree and some more guava, papaya, curry leaves and some flowering plants, tulsi, mango plant, banana. Friends, we have seen just now a plant and its part. The part of the plant which is under the soil is the root system and those parts which are above the soil is the shoot system. This shoot contains all the other parts of the plant like stem, bud, flower, branches, fruit and leaf. Now, you know the function of each part of the plant. Now, I think you can answer these questions also. DAV fixes a plant in the soil. What is it? Root. DAV supports a plant and keeps it upright. That is stem. Leaf has DAV in it to prepare food and to give it its green color. That is chlorophyll. Fruits have DAV in them which germinate to form plants, that is seed. Now students, in class 4, our topic is in the plants, we are going to see that part which is not visible to us, that is the root. We will explore more about the root and understand it in a better way. So our topic for class 4 is roots. Do you know? There are two types of roots. Surprised to know? Yes. Let me show you those two types of roots. See, I have drawn two types of roots for you. These are present in different types of plant. First one is called tap root and the next one is fibrous root as given in your book also. Now, how we can define the root? It is an underground part of the plant. As the plant grows, its root become thick and woody and with a corky outer layer. Types of root are of two types, tap and fibrous root. Now look at this picture very carefully. What do you mean by tap root? A tap root is you can see this is a soil. Tap root is a single long root with thin roots arising from it. It can be thin root also, it can be thick root also. Now those plants which are having tap root are beans, rose, ladyfinger, neem and peepal. But other than this also, these are the examples given in the book. But if you'll go in the nature and you will see yourself, observe yourself, you will find many more such taproots. But I will suggest you, after once you will free from the COVID-19, then only you will go outside and just search this type of roots, and then you show the things to your teachers also. Fibrous root. One another type of root where many roots arise from the base of the stem. You can see in a branched way. Thin roots arise from the base of the stem in a branched way. And the examples are grasses, cereals like wheat and rice, and banana. By saying only and by showing only these two pictures to you, the idea will be not clear to you. First, let us see the book also. Once the diagram is more clear, I think, in the book. Tap and fibrous root. Tap root. Single long root. With thin roots arise from it. Examples are given. Fibrous root. In which many roots arise from the base of the stem. Now, students, let us see some of the example of the tap and fibrous roots plant. Now look carefully. Is that it is matching with this tap root? Yes. Single long root with thin roots arising from it. So coriander plant is an example of tap root. It is having tap root. Now I have collected some very easily available plants which are grasses. Now look at these grasses and its roots. Now match with this structure. It's matching with this one. It is fibrous root. Many thin roots arise from the base of the stem. So grasses have fibrous roots. Now students, look at this root. It is given tap root and fibrous root. The diagrams, very clear diagrams are given. Tap and fibrous. Tap root, single long root with thin roots arising from it. Examples are also shown here. Fibrous roots are those in which many roots arise from the base of the stem, and this type of roots tends to taper downwards. And some examples are also given. The thing will be more clear if you see, observe, and take out more and more samples and observe them yourself. So for now, for part 1, this much only. Keep on revising the chapter 1 question answers and along with this, what I have taught today. Bye.